Do you like gifts? Huh? You like gifts? I love them. There's only been one gift I wasn't real pleased with. And that was 1 year at work, my wife sent me flowers. Yeah, of course, you know, they had to make a big deal out of it. Carry them out in the middle of the shop, put them on my bench. And oh boy, did they make fun of me. That's been the only gift I've never really been excited about. We like gifts, don't we? What's the neatest thing about a gift? It's free. Unwrapping it? How many of you like to unwrap things? Yeah, I even like it when UPS brings me something and I gotta fight through all them peanuts, you know? Get down to my goodies, feel like it's a big box of cereal. Looking for that special little surprise. Remember those days, don't we? Gifts are good. Gifts are exciting. And God has given each one of us a gift in our heart when we come to know Him. He's placed a spiritual, special gift just for you. So with that being said, I need to ask you this morning, who are you? Who are you? What gift has God given you? And then how can it be used today in the ministry in which God has placed you? Now, I'm not going to say Overton, because there's a lot of ministries out there, and God has placed certain people in certain places at certain times to do a specific task. We've all been given different gifts. We've all been given different outlooks on things. But they come from the same God. The same Spirit gives to each as He decides. Gifts are needed for a work to perform orderly and to function properly as a Christian community. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 4 through 9, page 806 on the Blue Bible says this to us. I will always thank God for you because His grace given you in Christ Jesus. For in Him you have been enriched in every way, in all your speaking and in all your knowledge, because our testimony about Christ was confirmed in you. Therefore, you do not lack any spiritual gift. As you eagerly wait for our Lord Jesus Christ to be revealed, He will keep you strong to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God, who has called you into fellowship with His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, is faithful. Let's pray. Lord, we thank You for these words. We pray this morning, Father God, that Your holy word would be alive in our hearts, that our minds would just leap with ideas of these scriptures. Lord, just be with us as we study Your word, as we learn from it today. We pray for Your grace and Your mercy and Your presence in this time of the service. We thank You, Lord. We give You all the praise. This morning, I'd like us to go back and focus on verse number 7 of what we just read. And it says, therefore, you do not lack any spiritual gift as you eagerly wait for our Lord Jesus Christ to be revealed. This verse was written to the entire church at Corinth as they had many problems. This community of faith did not lack any spiritual gift. Likewise, here at the Overton AUB, we have just the right amount of spiritual gifting. Why do you say that? Is there one person here? No. I think there was 31. I counted them a little earlier. That's just enough for us to do this morning what God the Father has us to do. You know, if there was three people here, there would be just enough for us to do in this place what God has asked us to do. Whenever there's more than one, there's just enough. God has blessed us with many gifts in this room this morning. Many. I would love for our churches today to lose some of the titles that's been given. Words like clergy and pastor and minister, things like this. Because we're all ministers. We've all been called to share the good news of Jesus Christ to the world in which we walk and in which we work. I was telling Jamie this morning, my mom baked bread for years at Frankie's. That was a world of white flour and dust. And today she lives with some of the detriments of that world in her breathing and whatnot. But yet she was called to that job. All of us are ministers. We see in 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 9 and 10, it says this, but you are a chosen people. Say that with me. Chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. Think about that a little. Mercy is amazing. Mercy is when you roll through that stop sign and you don't get pulled over. Mercy is when the police car, black police car, last night coming home from shooting down through West Unity about 40. And I'm like, oops. And Kristen goes, Dad. I said, look, the old gas station. There sits an all black police car, no lights on. And it's 25. Slow down. Mercy. God's given us the ability to see around us differently. Rick Warren, in one of his stories, says about 20 years ago at Saddleback Church in Southern California, they had grown to approximately 500 people. And Rick Warren, the senior pastor, one morning said to the folks there, I'm out of energy. And the church is getting so big, I can't do it anymore. He said, as I read the Bible, it doesn't say I'm supposed to do it all anyway. I'll make you a deal. If you'll do the ministry God's gifted you to do, then I will do my part, which is to make sure you're all fed. Warren said, he literally shook hands with everybody in the church at that point in time. Shortly after that discussion, the church began exploding with growth. I sat at the track last night with Dell and Nash. Dell was talking to all these people I'd never seen before. I may never see him again, but he knew. And I could tell by the way they were sharing salami and all sorts of goodies back and forth, they'd hung out a while. Because I'm not sure I would have ate something like that, not knowing the guy handing it to me. See, he knows folks I'll never know. Norma knows folks I'll never know. We all have been called to be ministers, to grow. One of the key words I see in verse 7 is this word manifest. The word manifest means to make plain. Spiritual gifts are given, are manifested within us to make plain God's gifting in our lives. Now, I like to talk. Some folks say, I have a gift to gab. One guy said I could sell an Eskimo an ice cube. I like to talk. I don't like to get in front of people. One-on-one, I'm fine. But just the anticipation of y'all coming here this morning, I get really nervous. I may not appear to be nervous, but I'm jumping like crazy inside. But it's God's gift in me that allows me the grace to stand here and to share with y'all this morning. It's the gift He's given me. Secondly, we've all been given at least one spiritual gift for the common good or profit of the church. Ephesians 4, verses 14 through 16 says this, "Then we will no longer be infants, tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of men in their deceitful scheme. Instead," here's our choice, "speaking the truth in love, and we will in all things grow up into Him who is the head, that is Christ. For Him the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love. As each part does its work." Each part. You know what? You're a part. You have a part. You might look at something totally different than everybody else and never ever say a word. And somebody might have needed to see that. You all have a part. If there's something happening, not happening, should be happening, and God's burned that desire in your heart, come talk to us. I'll never forget Brenda a year ago thought we needed a float. And I said, "Your idea, you headed up." "No. I'll help." We won second prize at Kunkel. It was a huge parade. Isn't that amazing? As each one of us do our part, God's work will be done. Many of us this morning have been given a gift. It's pretty special. Should be. 1 Corinthians 12:11 tells us that the Spirit gives to each one just as He determines. If you would like help, we handed out some surveys here a while back. Fill those out. Get a hold of Debbie and I. We want to sit down with you and go through that stuff with you so you can identify with yourself who you are. We want to pray with you and help you grow into what God has called you to be. I want to leave you with a song this morning. I ran across this week, but I really enjoy it.
Chains of a past defeat. You can suddenly see through the sweet harmony a path for your wandering feet. I'm gonna sing just as long as it takes for a song to make sad heavy spirits free. I'm gonna keep making music that carries the secret that Jesus is liberty. I'm gonna turn off the sound that will drag people down to the bitterness on the sea. With a sweet happy tune, just give in to the doom and gloom. Life's a waiting room for the blow that threw us all in. I can't sympathize when before my eyes is a hope shining bright as day. I've gotta follow the song that keeps drawing me on with my feet dancing all the way. I'm gonna sing just as long as it takes for a song to make sad and your spirits free. I'm gonna keep making music that carries the secret that Jesus is liberty. I'm gonna turn off the sound that will drag people down to the bitterness while we see. With a sweet happy tune, he is coming soon for his children like you and me. I'm gonna sing just as long as it takes for a song to make sad heavy spirits free. I'm gonna keep making music that carries the secret that Jesus is liberty. I'm gonna turn off the sound that would drag people down to the bitterness on the sea. With a sweet happy tune, he is coming soon for his children like you and me. Yeah, with a sweet happy tune, he is coming soon for his children like you and me.
This morning, Lord, for this time you've given us, for the words and the songs that have went forth, Father God, we just pray that hearts received and minds were opened this morning to your holy word. Father God, we ask that you bless us this day and all our travels till we return this evening, Lord. We just pray that your will be done in all our lives. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Thank you, folks. Amen.